I conduct empirical research to understand the dynamic behavior of financial markets and financial institutions using data from around the world. I have a current research program that's particularly focused on understanding bank behavior in reaction to getting government support. Whilst they do try to avoid it, in critical times, governments do provide support for the banking sector because they're trying to avoid bank failures and the significant costs that brings for society at large. As we saw in the 2007-08 global financial crisis, the scale of government support for the banking sector has really been unprecedented. Widespread support of banks by the government, especially if it's ongoing and expected, is likely to create this moral hazard problem that economists know very well. And that is essentially a change in behaviour as a result of getting this protection. And so banks are likely to take more risk, offer cheaper loans in order to increase their market share and to be more competitive against the rival banks. The problem is that in the long run, if the government continues to provide support for the banking sector will continue to take excessive risks because market discipline will significantly weaken. The key recommendations coming out of this research program is that there needs to be a delinking of the government and banks. And also capital standards can be improved because we found in the research that banks having higher capital are less inclined to take excessive risks. Going forward, we would all be better off if we can achieve that fine balance between financial stability and financial flexibility.